Attitudes.
And a very good afternoon, everyone. Welcome to Issues and Attitudes. My name is Jeff Owens, director of WEIU TV and radio. My co-host is Alicia Haynes.
Welcome back, students.
Yes, and first day of school, we thought we would invite Tanya Willard. She is the director, the new director of the new student and family programs here at Eastern Illinois University.
Yes.
Welcome, Tanya.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
Appreciate you coming in today on this kind of wet Monday.
My pleasure.
There you go. Well, let's talk a little bit about, I mean, you off mic, you were saying how busy last week was to try to get the students on campus, moved in, prepared, indoctrinated, and all that stuff. So talk about last week.
Sure. So last week was actually the culmination of a very busy summer and spring semester of getting students oriented. We had transfer students going through orientation since last March, and freshman students started going through orientation in June. And so last week was kind of the culmination in making sure that they got here, got comfortable, were confident starting classes today. We brought our student leaders back. We're doing training all last week, and then kick things off with move-in day on Thursday. And it has been just go, go, go since then.
And you're busy all weekend, right? Thursday, Friday, Saturday, Sunday?
You betcha.
So what all happened over the weekend? Tell us, just give us some highlights if you would.
Sure. So Thursday, we had move-in day. Friday, we started with Prowl, which is our welcome 6 weeks of welcome weekend. Started that off with convocation Friday morning, followed by their traditional new student photo in O'Brien Stadium. Then some academic meetings. The students met with small groups. Friday evening, they had some social programs that went on Friday night. Then on Saturday, we did Jumpstart, which is our big annual day of service. We coordinate with Civic Engagement and Volunteer Office, and we sent them out to about 23 different service projects in and around Charleston and on campus. Saturday night, more fun on campus. And yesterday we were out at Lake Charleston for the third or fourth annual EIU Takes the Lake. Students were canoeing, playing yard games, just hanging out, eating food, getting off campus for a little bit. And then, of course, last night we had first night.
There you go. Cool. And today, classes begin.
At you bet.
Was this your first year as director?
It is. It is. I've been here 7 months.
Oh,
yeah,
wow.
7 months.
So what was that like, you know, your first year, and you just get thrown right into the mix of things?
Yeah, so the funny part is that my second day here, I think, was our spring orientation day, and
oh, nice.
So it was welcome, go to work. So I feel like I felt a little bit more prepared doing this than I did when I was here in January, so I've had a little bit of time to gear up for it. So my background is in orientation, and mm-hmm. so I feel very comfortable doing welcome week and Prowl and orientation. The difference was mm-hmm. just kind of doing it here and knowing the people to contact when, you know, I can't figure out how to turn the lights on, or how do I reserve a room, or how do I get the field reserved, or how do I get golf carts? So that was a big thing for me, I think,
very
this year.
Cool.
Of course,
yeah.
The thing that everybody has been talking about, and there's been a little bit of press on it, and of course, we got to wait till the numbers come out, but it seems busier. It seems like there's a lot more people here. So when you think about how busy you were Thursday and Friday, it looks like that Eastern's enrollment will be up, and that's got to be exciting news for, you know, university around. Right?
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah, we had probably over 1,000, definitely over 1,000 people at convocation on Friday, which is really exciting. We are expecting, we hope, around 820 freshmen, a little over 400 transfer students. We are still orienting students even today. Students are getting admitted, and so we're doing kind of on-demand orientations today and getting students into class, so they're still coming. Even today, they'll be coming all week, so it's awesome.
That sounds like my generation.
There's always a few that, you know, get lost. I found one lost student here today. She was looking.
Those are the best ones.
Yeah, she was looking for a classroom that begins with two on the first floor, and I'm going, if you go up a floor, your odds will
increase.
You're close.
Increase. You're so, close.
There you go. When you talked, and the big thing is that, you know, the students, you know, they come, they get ready, but the parents are the ones that really are the ones that probably have more questions than the students.
Yep.
When you talked to some parents this past weekend, what were their questions, concerns, thoughts, and overall feeling about EIU?
So I did not interact with a ton of parents over the weekend, but throughout the summer, I spoke with a lot of parents. I hosted a session first for families during every one of those 18 sessions throughout the summer. And I think the general concern is, will my student be successful here? What can I expect when I send my kid off to college? Some of these families have done this a couple of times. For some of them, it's their only kid. For some of them, it's their last kid they're sending off to college. And so they're just, I think the general question is, you know, what can I expect from Eastern as a family member? Will my student be successful? You know, what happens if XYZ happens? And so I think we do a really good job of making students and their families feel comfortable here. So I hope when they came back to move in that they weren't feeling anxious anymore. I hope we kind of figured that out during the summer, and they were feeling good when they got here last week.
You were a little excited because there wasn't any major events you had to do today other than appear on this show, of course.
Sure.
But what else goes on this week for some of the new students and transfer kids who are just here at Eastern?
Sure. This week there's get acclimated to class. So please, everybody, if you remember nothing of what I say while I'm here today, please go to class. Next week, on Wednesday the 29th, we have Pantherpalooza, which will be on one of the quads. The other thing that's also going on next Wednesday is the Volunteer Fair and the Business Expo, which is in the morning from 10:45 to 2 p.m. So if you participated in Jumpstart this weekend, or even if you didn't and you want to get involved in volunteerism and civic engagement, or you want to learn more about different resources that are in the community, join us for that next Wednesday. The best thing that I can tell you, if you want to learn about what's happening on campus during Prowl, which continues through fall break, is to get onto Panther Life, which is Eastern's very own app. So go to your app store, look for EIU Panther Life. There's a freshman track, there's a transfer track, so there's something in there for everybody.
People who have no idea what Pantherpalooza or the Volunteer Fair, can you give us a synopsis of those?
Sure. The Volunteer Fair and the Business Expo, so that is coordinated by my good friends over in Civic Engagement Office, and it's a great way to get connected with different resources around the community, different local businesses that are here to help students get acclimated and find their spot here on campus. If you want to learn more about how to get involved in volunteerism, that's also a great way to do that. That's the Volunteer Fair and Business Expo next Wednesday morning. The Pantherpalooza is our kind of big expo for registered student organizations. Here at Eastern, we have about 200 registered student organizations, and all of them would love to get to know our new students, recruit them, and help get them involved. And so I always tell new students when they come for orientation, think about something that you did in high school that you really loved and you want to keep doing here at Eastern, and maybe find something that maybe you didn't have an opportunity to do while you were in high school that you'd like to try out for the first time. I guarantee you there is something here for you for both of those things. And if there's not, start up your own organization. But Pantherpalooza is a great way to take that first step in getting involved.
And that's next Wednesday as well?
Next Wednesday from 2 to 5.
Okay. Now, when you talk about the new students that are coming in, I like to specifically talk a little bit about the freshmen, because those are the ones I think that we're probably always more concerned about.
Sure.
The transfer kid has had a couple of years of college,
sure,
or maybe 1 year at another college. But when a freshman student comes in, and you start, and you're either a friend of them or you know somebody, and you see them struggling of going to class, maybe not getting it, not making friends. What should the outside people do? And then if you're that student who's struggling, what should you do?
I always tell students to ask for help, and that's really tough to do sometimes, because I think with freshmen, a lot of times they think they're the only ones that are feeling. They think that everyone around them, you know, has figured out and they all know what they're doing, and that's not always the case. And so I always say, like, reach out and ask for help, whether that's your RA, whether that's a professor, if that was your orientation leader this summer, if that's your roommate. Make sure that if you need help that you're reaching out there and asking for help. There's tons of people here on campus. It's one of the things that I love about Eastern, is that, you know, this idea of being all in is not just, you know, a marketing slogan that we stick on a poster or on a flyer. I think it's something that we live every day. And so I think that there are tons of people out there ready to help. And so I always say, you know, like, make sure that you're asking for help. Whether that's through my office, I'm always happy to help connect students to resources. If that's an RA, a professor, whoever it is, make sure that you're letting somebody know that you might need some help.
Okay. Going to class is obviously the most important thing.
Yep.
And that's some of the things that, you know, when you are not required to go to class in theory, you know, how do you, when you talk to students and your folks talk to students and the PROW leaders and the emerging leaders all talk, how do you convince students that going to class is still the easiest way to start your learning process here at EIU?
How do I do that?
That's a tough question, I know.
Yeah. You know, I think the messages that the PROW leaders and the orientation leaders say is that that faculty actually know when students aren't in class, and half the part about being a student is just showing up. Go to class. The faculty know when you're there. They know when you're not there. If you miss a day of class, then that's just more that you're gonna have to make up later. One thing I always tell students is that it's super easy to get your grade to slide down. Like, it's really easy, but it's so hard to bring it back up. And I have taught classes before, and on the first day of class, I tell everybody, I was like, you all have a 4.0 in my class right now. Like, it is now your responsibility to keep that 4.0. Coming to class is the easiest way to do that.
That's a good answer, I like that, you know?
I think one of the best pieces of advice I got when it came to going to class was from a journalism professor. And he stood in the front of the class and he's like, do you realize that you're paying a huge amount of money, or your parents are paying a huge amount of money just for you to go to class? He's like, I don't understand why it's so hard. Just go to class.
Just go to class.
You know, it's a waste of money if you don't go.
Yeah. I love the class, the books and the electricity food,
yep.
Gas, all that stuff. When you think about East Carolina University, I mean, you said you've had a kind of a crazy path how you got here. So we're talking to Tanya Willard. She's the new director of New Student and Family Programs here at Eastern Illinois. But you started in January. But talk about how you ended up at Eastern and where you started and a little bit about you now.
Oh, gosh. So before I got here, I have always been in higher education. I have done nothing else. I've always been involved in student affairs. I fell into it like most student affairs people do, which was completely by accident. and I have worked as a student affairs higher education person in North Carolina, and did that just thinking, oh, I'm just going to do this. I'm going to go get a master's degree in something actually related to my major. And I was there for 2 years and fell in love with it, loved working with college students, and decided I should go get a master's degree and do some other things. And so I moved to Atlanta, and I worked at Emory University for 13 years, did a master's degree in higher education part-time while I was there, spent about 8 of those years at Emory doing orientation, new student and family programs, and in 2012, after lots of prodding from my master's degree thesis advisor, who kept saying, hey, when are you going to do that PhD? And I kept saying, not this year, buddy. I finally decided I was ready. And in 2013, I headed off to Miami University in Ohio and did a doctoral PhD program in student affairs and higher education. And when I graduated, I was like, what do I want to do with this fancy pants degree with these 3 little letters? Well, I don't know what to do. And I realized that I love working with new students and families, and that's really my professional passion. I actually met some random person and who told me about Eastern Illinois. She had a daughter who went in here and loved it, and this job came open, and here we are. So,
all right.
It was almost like it was going
to happen. Yeah.
You said Maine was involved somewhere,
yeah,
too.
Yeah, I'm originally from Maine, actually, yeah.
So Maine to Atlanta to Ohio.
Maine to Tennessee.
North Carolina.
Yeah, all over the place.
I'm gradually just moving my way west. Yeah. I just keep moving further west. So, yeah.
So you've had 7 months here to live. I assume you live in Charleston.
I do.
How do you like Charleston and Eastern and, you know, all that when you think about this as your new home for a while?
Yeah, I love it. I love the students here. I was blown away when I came in November for my interview. I instantly just felt at home, and I knew that this is where I wanted to be. And then I started meeting the students that work in my office, and I don't know that I've ever worked with a group of students that I just enjoy working with so much. And not just the students in the office, just Eastern students in general are just wonderful people. I really enjoy working with them. I love living in Charleston. I, you know, lived in Atlanta for a long time, thought I was a city girl, and then realized I wasn't, and moved to the middle of nowhere, Ohio, and realized that I really enjoy living in cornfields. And so I have a little dog, and so this is a super walkable town, and so, yeah, I love it, just getting being able to get out and just walk the dog in the cornfields and all that. That's great.
That's awesome.
Yeah.
When what do students ask you the most? And what do they ask you about the most, about the campus, but about, you know, what they should be doing here at Eastern?
Oh, that's a tough one. I think a lot of students have questions about getting involved. I think a lot of students, I think, have been doing that either weren't involved in high school and want to test the waters of getting involved, or were super involved in high school and want to continue that involvement. So I think that those are questions that we get pretty frequently. And of course, a week away, I would say go to Pantherpalooza, plug for that. So I would say do that. I would say getting involved, how to get involved, that's probably the biggest question.
But can a student do getting involved with too much, and then that hurts their...
Oh, definitely.
So do you kind of temper some of them down a little bit or not?
Yeah, and that's why I usually say, go to Pantherpalooza. And this is all just caveat. This is my first Pantherpalooza, not my first kind of rodeo.
Oh, the pressure's on. It has to be the best one ever. You didn't
know? Oh, it'll be. But not my first rodeo with the student activities fair in general. So what I usually tell students is, go visit those, the tables. Sign up for as much stuff as you want to sign up for. And then, try those things out and kind of dial it back a little bit. You're not going to have time for 13 different organizations and class and maybe a job on campus or off campus. You're just not going to have time for all of that. But go to Pantherpalooza, sign up, and just kind of see where your passions are. And as the time goes on, you'll choose those two or three or four, however many that you're comfortable with, things that you feel really strongly about and feel really passionately about.
Transfer students, how are they different from the freshmen? I mean, do they kind of have a little feeling about college, but how do you treat them as opposed to the incoming freshmen in terms of getting them indoctrinated into the EIU way?
Yeah, so the thing with transfer students, obviously, is that they've been to college somewhere, and so they've done college, and so one of the things that we try to do in the office of the new student and family programs is to honor the fact that they have done some college somewhere else and not to treat them like a freshman. The thing is, it's kind of similar to my own situation. I've done orientation in other places. I've just not done it here.
Yeah.
And so I think that's really similar with a transfer student. I can say we can talk about things like class registration or student involvement or volunteer opportunities or academic advising. And they have a kind of a general sense of what those things mean, but they don't necessarily know what it means here at Eastern. And so part of what we have to do here is make sure that we're getting them connected to those things so they can translate what they have known previously to how that works here at Eastern.
Good answer again. How do we continue, or how do we increase school spirit so the students show up for not just sporting events, but all events, the homecomings and Pantherpaloozas and stuff? Do you think that's part of your job or not?
Ooh, that's tough.
I didn't say this was going to be an easy interview.
Yeah, you sure didn't.
I am very mean and tough.
Yeah, I mean, I think that's kind of a misconception, I think, maybe about my office, is that we only do new student and family programs, and so we're only around during orientation. And I think part of what my office should be doing is setting the tone for school spirit, involvement, kind of excitement about being here at Eastern. So I hope that through things like First Night or Quaking in the Quad or Up All Night or Pantherpalooza, that we're getting that school spirit going, and that it's something that's maintained, throughout. Ask me this question next year after I've been here for a full year, and I'm happy to come back on the first day of class next year, and we'll talk about it.
All right, you are booked.
I think that's the golden question, though, is, how do you stop student apathy?
Well, because I think part of the thing is that one of the things you've seen or that you'll maybe see or you've heard about Eastern is that, hey, it's a great school, classrooms are small, you can get involved in all these things, but when it comes to some of the spirit, we've kind of lacked that in the last, decade, maybe even longer, and a lot of it is because kids aren't from around here. they come from around, and so maybe they're Illinois fans or Indianapolis fans or Chicago fans. They're not EIU Panthers fans, and one of the things is I think that the whole campus has been trying to say, how do we get them to become that?
Yeah, and one of the things that I have noticed since I've been here is that, like, students wear Eastern gear all the time. Like, my previous institution, they wore, like, every other school imaginable.
Well, I will say this. That is something that has changed here in the last few years. Okay. That used to not be the way.
Yeah.
When I first got here 13 years ago, you rarely saw, or you didn't see near as much Panther Blue as you do now.
Yeah.
Eastern's done a really good job of trying to indoctrinate
well,
that.
Well, even my freshman year, that was 2 years ago. You know, all you saw was Wisconsin T-shirts and U of I T-shirts.
Yeah, I think that they've made a good, we've made a good effort in changing that. So. Mm-hmm.
Free T-shirts change that.
So that's always a good way to go. That is always a good way to go. One thing that I feel like I've noticed here is that it's tough to kind of find out about some of the things that are going on. And, you know, like, we have been talking about this Panther Life app, and there's a ton of stuff on Panther Life. So, if students download Panther Life and are checking it, there's a whole bunch of stuff going on campus. It's just, you know, it's hard, I think, if there's not a centralized place when you can go and say, hey, what's going on campus this weekend? There are some things on Panther Life.
Does your office run Panther Life, or is that kind of a bunch of offices?
It's we don't run it for sure, but there are a whole bunch of folks in student affairs who work together to make sure that we're getting those things on Panther Life. Housing has a whole bunch of things on Panther Life, civic engagement, athletics, the arts. There's a whole bunch of things on there on Panther Life if students just go download it. And then continuously just go back there and check and say, hey, what's going on this weekend?
Oh, that's cool.
Go look on Panther Life. There's a whole bunch of stuff.
Cool. Does your office, well, let's talk about this because we're about 7 minutes off. Let's talk about, I know we've talked a lot about getting the kids indoctrinated in this first week and what's going on. What else happened? What other events do you guys put on as the school year and academic year here goes?
Sure. In September 21st and 22nd, we also host Family Weekend. And that is a wonderful, like, I always tell families, like, come back and visit us anytime. But if you can come back during Family Weekend, that's a great time to come back. There's a football game. There's breakfast with the president.
Is that the concert?
There's no concert.
No concert this year?
No concert. But lots of different, there's a murder mystery dinner theater.
Those are always fun.
Yeah. I never know what those are called. But we've got that going on. Movies, like tons of stuff for the whole entire family. If you've got like little brothers and sisters or cousins or whoever, bring them that weekend. There's a ton of stuff going on.
Okay. Other events, is it more in the fall or spring? Or?
Well, let's see. We will be starting with transfer orientation in October, if you can believe it, for students who will be joining us transferring here in the spring. We start transfer orientation October, November, December, and then we start right back up again with transfer orientation in the spring semester for students coming in the fall. And then we're always looking for great student leaders to join our office. We have debut leaders, which we're going to be renaming orientation leaders, prowl leaders, senior prowl leaders. And so we are always looking for students to come help welcome our new students and their families. And so those positions will be available starting in the fall, probably end of September, October.
Now, did I read wrong or did I read correctly that you also provide military student assistance?
Yeah, the Military Student Assistance Center is also coordinated through my office as well.
So what exactly does that mean? Or if you're a military student or you know someone is?
Yeah, so if you yourself are active duty, if you're a veteran, if you are a dependent of a veteran, we can help connect students to resources on campus. If you have questions about any of your veteran benefits, the GI Bill, post 9/11 bill, any of that stuff, if you have questions about any of that, feel free to stop by the office. We can help students get pointed in the right direction. We host the Veterans Day ceremony in November, and so we're a great resource for military students as well.
There you go. Anything over there?
No, I just wanted to know about Family Weekend. So that's always been a staple of Eastern, you know.
Well, somebody asked me this weekend about if there was going to be a concert or not, so that's why I brought that up. The other thing I wanted to talk a little bit about, not just about the school spur, but mentoring or tutoring, I mean, do you direct them to the students to the proper places so that they have someone they can kind of rely on if they're struggling in class or on campus?
Yeah, I mean, I completely envision my role and the role of the students who work in my office as being a resource. So students, and this is what I told told families, when they came for orientation, like, from the minute your student comes here to the second they walk across the stage, my office can serve as a resource. So if they need tutoring, if they need help with anything, if they are having roommate conflicts, if they have questions about dining, whatever it is, and they don't know where to start, they can always start new student family programs and we'll help get them connected.
What if one of your students or even a student on campus has an idea for an event? Should they come to you?
Sure, absolutely. Yeah, absolutely.
I mean, and most of the students help run these events, too. It's not just you. You kind of guide them and let the students be involved so they can...
Sure. The evening programs that we do during Prowl are coordinated through the university board, and so if you've got an idea for that, I would suggest going to university board. But if you have ideas about things that we could be doing during orientation, during the summer, or even during Prowl, please let us know. We'd love to get some new ideas.
Okay. A couple minutes left. We always like to end the show with just rapid-fire questions. Some relate to your job, some relate to Eastern, some may not.
Okay, great.
And we also let Annalisa answer because
I like
to throw her off.
I'm a little terrified, but let's
do it. Since it was our first meeting, I didn't go terribly hard, I don't think.
Okay.
Maybe a couple curveballs. We'll see.
Okay.
Last book that you've read.
Last book that I read. I read recently, I think it's called The Lost Girls, about serial killings of sex workers in Long Island.
Oh, cool. No, I just mean it's cool.
It was a great book. I highly recommend it. It was a great one.
I should probably clarify that. Carrie Fisher's autobiography.
So far, the best thing about Eastern Illinois?
Students.
Oh, my God. The fact that I have a staff. I'm editor-in-chief of the Daily Eastern News.
Nice.
And one of the things that we were worried about was not getting, you know, freshmen to come in and write. And everyone wants to come and write, so knock on wood that we keep them.
That's amazing.
It's always nice.
What do people not know about Tanya Willard?
That I speak Spanish.
All right.
Oh, cool.
Mm-hmm.
Alicia?
I collect records.
Collect records. That's good.
Nice.
Okay, when you think of the first day of school, take yourself back to first, second, third, fourth. What comes to your mind? What do you think about when you have first day of school?
At any point?
Yeah, at some point. Mostly when you're younger. I mean,
I remember that when I was in kindergarten, I was terrified of making friends, that I wasn't gonna make friends because my best friend at the time went to a different school across the street, and it was absolutely the most traumatic thing in my life. And I remember in kindergarten walking up to Melissa Roberts and asking her if she would be my friend.
That's so sweet. do you want collectively or one day? Well, I remember getting those weird, like, butterfly feelings. Like, I felt completely sick, and this is the first year that I haven't gotten that feeling.
Wow.
And it's my senior year, I think.
We were talking about this the other day, and a lot of us remember the metal lunchboxes.
Yes.
Remember the metal lunchbox?
Yes.
When I was a kid, I remember that. My mom had them, but we weren't allowed to touch them because, of course, you know, it's vintage at that point. But my generation had the plastic ones.
Yeah. I had a Muppets lunchbox that
Everybody remembers the metal lunchbox.
Yep.
So, last question. Who is your favorite all-time teacher or professor growing up?
Oh, man.
High school or college?
Gosh. Favorite professor. I had a Spanish teacher in high school, Mr. Van Werkhoven. Hands down, favorite teacher.
Nikki Height, she was my journalism teacher in high school.
All right. Well, Tanya Willards, welcome to East Carolina University.
Thank you.
I appreciate you. You survived your first fall admin day, so we're all
in. Yes, cool. We are all in.
School's here. Classes are going on. We'll have you back in maybe even earlier in the year, but for sure a year from now. We'll talk about how everything's going. So welcome.
Wonderful.
And good job on this weekend. Everything went well.
Thank you.
This is HitMix 88.9 WEIU.
Eastern Illinois University's very own. This is HitMix 88.9 WEIU.